Parshas Noach, Tovshin Ayin Ches. We finally get to say now Tovshin Ayin Ches here. We're happy to be back in our friendly confines, Bika Cholam of Lakewood. And we're here in Parshas Noach. Inevitably, we talk about the Mabul. And the Mabul is one very, very fascinating part of the Torah. And it's a part of the Torah that everybody, and we've said this almost every year, that the picture that we have in our mind of the Mabul is undoubtedly the picture we had when we were very young children. And hopefully as we get older and we progress, we begin to understand more of the Midrashim, more of the Rashis in the Parsha, more of the Mefarshim on the Parsha, and understand that the Mabul was a tremendous, tremendously deep occurrence that happened to the world. And although we're actually beginning year number 9 of our Shiurim in a few weeks, the actual anniversary is a couple of weeks from now, but now basically we're getting really, now that we're doing Parshas Noach, the first Shiur on the Parshias of this year, we're actually going into our 9th year of Shiurim on the Parshias and Yom Tovim, and I find it to be extremely incredible. And for that, I'm very, very grateful to HaKadosh Baruch Hu for giving me this tremendous chus and this tremendous opportunity to do something that started as a, I don't want to say it started as a joke, but it started sort of as a fun little thing 8 years ago. And here we are, 8 years later, beginning our 9th year, and just the fact that we are approaching 400 Shiurim now, which are Shiurim online, Shiurim in audio, now Shiurim being written up in the newspapers, the fact that we are approaching 400 different Shiurim is just unreal for me. It's hard for me to even comprehend that. And the Pasuk tells us in our Parsha, B'chodesh HaSheni, in the 2nd month, B'shiva Asar Yoim L'chodesh, on the 17th day of the month, B'yoim HaZeh, on this day, Nifku Kol Mayonis Tehoim Rabbah, V'arubois HaShamayim Niftachu. On the 17th day of the 2nd month, on the 17th day of Chodesh Cheshvan, and today is actually the first day of Rosh Chodesh Cheshvan, on that day, everything went crazy. The water just started coming down, the drains were stopped, however you want to think of it, everything went, water kept accumulating. V'yehi ha-geshem al ha-oretz, there was rain for arboim yoim v'arboim loilo, for 40 days and 40 nights. And v'hamayim gavru ma'oid ma'oid, the water was strong and it got high. V'yigbru ha-mayim al ha-oretz chamishim u'ma'as yoim. There was so much water that it really lasted and it kept rising. It was a tremendous amount of water. Okay, so Nesiv HaShalom brings a very, very interesting point out of these psukim. These psukim that we just read now tell us, we know that that Noach had prepared for the Mabul, and what's happening here is that the Mabul actually finally happened. And when you look at these psukim, the Nesiv HaShalom points out something. It's very interesting to note that in all these psukim that say that the Mabul was strong and there was so much water and the Mabul happened, we do not find any mention of the name of Hashem. We do not find in these psukim that Hashem carried out this occurrence, this punishment to the world. And it's unlike even Sodom v'Amoira, which we're going to learn about in a couple of weeks. In Sodom v'Amoira, the psukim tell us Hashem himtir al Sodom v'Amoira gofris v'eish, that Hashem went ahead and punished Sodom v'Amoira. V'yehi b'shacheis elikim es orea kikar, that Hashem went, once again we see another pasuk, the cities of the plain, Hashem was the one that went and punished it. And here it just seems in our psukim here in Parshas Noach, it seems that the water and the drainage system, they just went out of control somehow on their own. We do not see any mention of God in these psukim. So Nesiv HaShalom tells us a very, very interesting lesson that we see here. Nesiv HaShalom says that there are different punishments that Hashem uses at different times. Hashem may mete out punishment in different ways. But the most severe punishment that Hashem could punish any person is where Hashem Kaviyochel says, I am out of the picture. There's no hashkacha. I am removing myself, Kaviyochel, Hashem says, I am removing myself from the equation. Dovra Melech, we know, asked, Al tashlicheni milfanecha. Dovra Melech said, do not throw me away. Do not close yourself out for me. Dovra Melech did not ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu, do not punish me. Dovra Melech asked that he should not have the punishment of Hashlacha, where Hashem says, you're on your own. I'm not here anymore. I'm letting you just, whatever happens, I'm letting loose, and whatever happens, happens. That's the worst punishment. That's called Hashlacha. So Dovra HaMelech asked, Al tashlicheni milfanecha. He didn't say, don't punish me. He said, just don't remove yourself, so to speak, from the equation. And that, says the Nesiva Shalom, that is what the Mabul was. The people of that generation were so corrupt that Hashem took away all the hashkacha. Hashem said, all the normal laws of nature that I created, off the table. I'm not watching over, I'm not policing this world anymore. And Hashem just let everything go. I'm not watching over it anymore. And to a Jew especially, that is the toughest punishment. Hashem was so upset at the Dor HaMabul that they got the most severe punishment, that Hashem removed his hashgacha from the world for that amount of time. So we see that the name of Hashem was not found in the psukim that described the happening of the Mabul, because Hashem had removed himself from the equation. And when Hashem removes himself, anything can happen. And we see what happened. That everything just went totally against all the laws that are set up for nature. It's as if it happened on his own, without the direct direction of Hashem, which is the normal way of the world. The Torah tells us in Parshas Bechukosai, Im Bechukosai Telechu, if you will go in the way of my laws, the Torah tells us, V'nosati Gishmeichem Be'itam, I will let it rain and I will give you rain in its proper time. There are laws of nature that Hashem set into motion at the beginning of creation, which we read about in last week's parasha, Parshas Bereishis. The laws of the sun and the moon, the laws of the heaven and the earth, the laws of the sand on the shore, keeping the waters at bay and not allowing the waters to flood and completely flood the world. So Hashem tells us, Im b'chukosai telechu, I gave you laws of the Torah. If you follow the Torah, if you follow the laws that I give you, then Hashem will keep his laws of nature. If you follow the laws, v'nosati gishmeichem b'itam, you'll have the rain at the proper time, because that is the way Hashem set up the world, that there should be prosperity, that there should be rain, that things should grow. But when the Torah, chas v'shalom, is not being followed, then all rules are off the table. V'nosati gishmeichem b'itam is a direct correlation of Im b'chukosai telechu, if you follow in the laws of the Torah. And that was what happened by the Mabul, that things had become so corrupt that the laws of nature, the laws of normal rain of the gishmeichem b'itam, were cancelled. By Sodom v'Amora, of course, there was corruption. The people of Sodom v'Amora were not your friendly neighbors, were not people that we necessarily would want to associate with. They were very troubled and they had a lot of problems. But the Nesiva Shalom says, Sodom and Amora were sort of, if we could call it, quote, a local corruption. Those cities had gone astray. Those people had gone bad. It was confined to those cities. So the wrath of Hashem was not so severe. The entire world had not become corrupt once again. So they were punished, but not with Hashlacha. Hashem turned over the cities, they were punished. But Hashem did not remove himself from the equation, and we see that Hashem himself carried out the punishment. And now listen to this beautiful thought that the Nesivut Shalom tells us. The Gemara, Mesechtas Erechin, that Tezayin Amid Beis tells us that it is a negative sign for a person if 40 days go by without any Yisurim or any Agmas Nefesh for the person. If a person goes 40 days and everything just seems so perfect, so peachy, everything is just rolling right along, the Gemara tells us that a person has to worry. And you know why? Because just as a shepherd takes a stick sometimes and he just taps the sheep and he taps them back into line if they're getting out of line, Hashem, we are the sheep, we are the flock of Hashem. And Hashem, sometimes Hashem gives us small messages to keep us in line. And you know what that means? That means that we have hashgacha, that Hashem cares about us, and Hashem is watching over us. And He gives us messages, sometimes they're small, sometimes they're a bit bigger and more severe messages. But you know what that shows? When not everything goes right, and we have this, we perceive something as a little bit trouble over here, a little bit trouble over there, big trouble over here. But you know what it means? It means Hashem is keeping us in line. That this hashgacha, that Hashem is telling us, you're my children, you're my flock, you're my sheep, I'm tapping you back in line. And it should be very comforting to every Jew to know that Hashem is with us. Yes, in the small picture, we feel that something's wrong. We feel that things are not right with us. But if we think a little deeper, we realize that it's Hashem. We don't understand it now, but Hashem is bringing us back in line because He's our Father and He cares about us. And the Dor HaMabul had lost that privilege. The Dor HaMabul lost the privilege where Hashem was watching over them. They lost the privilege that we all have, that Hashem will teach them a lesson because Hashem is their Father. Hashem removed Himself from the equation, and therefore the name of Hashem is removed from the tzukim that talk about the bringing of the Mabul. And the lesson here is one which is pretty obvious for us, that sometimes we feel in our lives that things are not going perfectly, things are not going so well. But you know what? That's Hashem's way of telling us, I care about you. I need to bring you back into line a little bit. It's called Hashgacha. Al Tashlicheni Lufanecha. We never want Hashem to remove Himself. And sometimes we feel, and we know, when Hashem reminds us, we know that it's Hashem who's with us and is watching over us. And that's really the lesson. And see, Shalom, when he reads a pasuk, he sees it different than we see it. He sees a pasuk and he understands that what we have to learn out of this pasuk. What we see, that the name of Hashem is not here, and that's a problem. We want the name of Hashem. We want the accompaniment of Hashem at all times. And that really is the lesson that we want to bring out of this parsha. Just to end off in the final minute here, I just want to thank, first of all the people that make this shiur happen, people that come to the shiur, Mr. Yosef Mutterpearl of the Southside Sandwich Shop, who we started the shiur, and actually he sent in his cholin tonight, once again, just to remind us of the good old days when we were back there. Of course, we have our own cholent every week here, but I want to thank Mr. Mutterpearl for hosting us for the few years when we started something that started off, it's not so funny anymore, almost 400 shiurim, and Yosef, you have a tremendous, tremendous chus for starting this thing off. I want to thank my weekly photographers and audiographers, Mr. Taylor, a chashmah friend I have over here, who has become our resident and chief videographer every week. And the schus should stand by every single one of you people, that you should all have the schus and the brachas that come with being Marbet Torah.